Thanks to the hospitality of the EOS 42, and it's a great pleasure to speak to you today about EOS Cannon and China in general. I'm, by the way, Larry Ma. I'm a co-founder of the EOS Cannon, which is one of the large community in China. So I will start with how we started. So EOS Cannon was founded at a very specific circumstance last year, September, when the market is dropping in China. And someone from our group, they came up with a very famous advertising slogan, Cannon, delighting you always, which is from a camera. And we like that because it's easy to remember, it's upbeat, and so it becomes our group's slogan. And we call us EOS Cannon. EOS Cannon, delighting you as always, become our group slogan. And our founder, Kai Su and Ricky, since then use the WeChat group to communicate to the new members about EOS basics, explain how EOS works, and also tell them how EOS gonna change the blockchain world. So if you notice, we are not the camera, but the cannon artillery firing EOS. Members of our group coming from all lines of business. We have geeks, professionals, artists, we have people from traditional business, and also people from internet and financial service side. So what we share in common is that we believe in EOS. We believe that's an unparalleled infrastructure which can allow us to build the large scale DApps which will change the world eventually. So we started with a WeChat group and now grew into a community and now a national brand in EOS. And under this brand, it enabled us to do more to contribute to the EOS ecosystem. So our members come from all over China, and we have two headquarters, one founding team from the Southwest China, Chengdu, and the other founding team based on Shanghai, East Coast. And we, so far we had meetups in other major cities like Beijing, Xiamen, and Hong Kong. And if you notice that there may be not too many Chinese active on Twitter or Telegram, that's because most of the Chinese are active using another set of tools. So for Twitter, we have Weibo in China. For Reddit, Medium or Steam, we have Bihu, which is a Steam-like, 8BTC and Golden Finance, and many other media to choose from. And for Telegram, the equivalent is WeChat. For the YouTube, we have the Youku. And a few other choices. So people are actually pretty active in China, but they're just chatting on different channels. So EOS Cannon has been about 8 months old. And some people may know us because of the EOS token. Inside our community, we have five different groups. And the top is the elite group, which has the EOS holding of 1 million plus per member. And we have the 100K EOS holding group and 10K, 50K, and 10K. And we also have a few EOS Cannon group, which for the new members, there is no requirement for the EOS holding. So far, we have about 1,000 active members, and the average holding is about 50K per member. So EOS Cannon's mission is that we want to make EOS better. Inside our community, we want to contribute to the EOS system actively instead of by passive holding the tokens. So the more supporters we get in our community and the more developers and the development resources we can secure. And then we can start more DApps and other cool projects initiatives, which will in turn bring in more attention and members to our community. And outside, we have a lot of partnership with other communities and interaction with other business partners. And by electing to be a block producer, it enables us to serve the ecosystem better and provide a stable platform for DApps. And we also have started a project incubation program and secured a venue in Shanghai. Also, we kicked off a developer training community which will help to coaching the developers and also attract more developers to join us. And here we are, we're trying to connect more global resources and cooperate. So that will make the whole ecosystem working better. So in March, we announced our book producer candidacy. This is a natural result we choose because we want to serve the ecosystem better. And we are both financially sound and technically capable of doing that to provide a stable book producer services. We are active in the Jungle and the ScholarNet testnet. And we have a dedicated tech team behind. Half of our co-founder team have a technical background as well. So, and also our contribution to the ecosystem is comprehensive. We have our community support, we have our media coverage, and we have a lot of projects in residence, and we also have business partnerships both inside China and outside. And also we stay firm in gardening the core principles and values of the EOS. We have reacted to mistakes, misunderstandings, confusions, and glitches in the past right away once we find it, and which we think that's very important to have the transparency in communication and whistleblowers to guarding those basic principles. So here we are. This is the first time we come out of Asia to meet in Europe. And we believe because of the language barrier and also because there's a line of different tool set we use to separate us. So it's important to have this communication and to cooperate globally. So in the past, we have actively translated first-hand information to cater the domestic audiences. And we have introduced the cool projects from overseas to China. And we have also prompted Chinese communities to interact with global leaders here. So we're continuing to do that. And that's why we're here. We're trying to do the same thing here, to put your voice and your opinion and your good ideas in front of a Chinese audience. Let them know what you have done. And in return, we also want you to know what we have done, so that we can plan our decentralized future together. So cooperation-wise, so far we have sponsored the hackathon in Tokyo, the Long Hash Hackathon, and we are proud to be a sponsor for this Hack Till Dawn event. And the end of this month, and by in June, I think we're going to the Hong Kong for the official EOSIO Hackathon. But we are looking forward to do more cooperation in the DApps area and media side. We believe that by doing more cooperation globally, that will eventually help us to build the better ecosystem, and it will increase the token holders' value for every community member. So this is a one-page introduction for the EOS in China. There are a lot more players from China which will not be fitting this page, but I just name a few to give you examples. So the landscape is pretty diversified. We have, say, Hello EOS, WenCloud, Oracle Chain, which have very strong strengths in the technical side. And EOS Gravity and EOS Cannon are famous for the community support. And there are a few others focusing on the exchange services, EOS Laomao and EOS WTZ. They are very famous for their QL leader. And also we have the first social app on EOS. The second row are some examples of community working on EOS wallet, blockchain, intellectual property services, index traffic, pooling, and other crypto medias. So as you can see, it's pretty crowded. And it's, diversified. I do hear that people may have the concern saying, what if the majority of the 21 blockchain producers are controlled by Chinese? What if the block producer on EOS is not geographically dispersed? Or will there be censorships on the EOS? I think the truth is that even majority of Chinese voters, they don't want to see this happening. They want to see a diverse and a decentralized world. And we talked to some of those Chinese block producers, and they do have the good intention to do whatever they can to make the world more balanced and decentralized. For example, our co-founder, Franco, he met with Huobi's CEO, Robin, just last week. And we talked about the outside doubt about exchange being part of the block producer. And Robin stated very clearly that they are not in this for the short-term interest. They want the system to be decentralized, and they want to actually ask their users to vote for overseas block producers. So, we also kicked off one of the media program we call Meet the Block Producer. With that, it is a questionnaire-based interview, which with the optional 1 to 2 minutes video greetings. We want to introduce overseas block producers to China audiences so that Chinese audience will know who they are, what's their vision, and what's their value point, and what they can contribute to the ecosystem so that they can vote for them. On the media side, we have also weekly and daily updates, and our comic artists have one or two stories about EOS every week. And we also have our internal KOL interview series. Our technical leader, Bing, he has also a tech daily column, which publishing on the Bihu. So we welcome all the possible cooperation on the media side. And if you are interested in working with other China crypto media, we can happy to introduce. So this is a quick list of current projects in residence. Those founders are from EOS Cannon communities. I won't go into all the details here, but I'm sure the list is gonna grow once the mainnet launched. These are some photos we took in Beijing, Xiamen, and Hong Kong meetups. The next one is coming up in Chengdu on the 5th. And we certainly will host more. And if any of you come to China, you're certainly welcome to meet us. This is our team. It's a coincidence that we choose Marvel comic heroes, same as EOS 42. I'll give a little bit of introduction. So in the middle is Kaisu, that's our founder, the Spider-Man. On the top, Ricky, he is also co-founder, the Iron Man. And me, Hawkeye. Mr. Gore is the Wolverine. Franco is Captain America, and Mr. Bing is Thor. Those are our contacts. So you're welcome to ask any questions and reach us. Thank you.